Evening Express, weekdays 5 to 7 Eastern.
The new homeowner is sharing her story for the first time and wants to remain anonymous.
It's a very loving home. It's got a very sweet spirit in this home.
She now owns the home in Mesa where Travis Alexander was killed by girlfriend Jody Arias in 2008. A year later, the new homeowner bought the place knowing little about its past.
So when we viewed the home, there were things missing, there were faucets missing, showers, there were carpet was missing, and so we thought the home had been vandalized.
It's no longer just a home where something bad happened. It's her home, and her family and kids live here. That's why videotaping inside wasn't allowed. Off camera, we got a tour of the place, and it's far from eerie, instead homey or comfortable.
Everything is new in the home. The dishwasher is new in the home. The carpet is new in the home. The paint is new. The shower is new. The faucets are new. The baseboards are new. The home is so popular, people drive by and some of these people get out and knock on the front door. We've had people pull in our driveway and stop and park and get out and get their cell phones out and take pictures of the house.
Does that bother you?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Rachel Fry is giving her family one of these drive-by tours.
We all want to see what it looks like now.
The national coverage has made this home famous, along with the prosecutor and defendant.
I very much love Travis, and I love Juan Martinez, and I love Detective Flores.
And when the trial is over, she's hoping the parade of looky-loos ends too.
I am hoping that once this trial is over, this can kind of become our home instead of Jody Arias's home or Travis Alexander's old home.
Our thanks to Crystal Cruz from KTVK. That's bizarre. They have to deal with the drive-bys there. The family bought the home in 2009 for about $200,000. They didn't know about the murders.
She's got a great attitude. When I was covering the Casey Anthony trial, people used to drive by George and Cindy's home, and that was so troubling for them until police sectioned off the area. But what happened to them? It's not uncommon. Folks, we looked into this, and it depends on where you're buying a house because states have different laws about whether you must be told about a crime on the property. They do have to let you know about structural issues, but not about a murder or killing. So here's my advice to you as a lawyer. Before you buy a house, always ask.